Come on, fool. Whip up the horse and get this laundry wagon moving.
Boy, this ain't no kind of business for man. Washing clothes and taking them around to the houses?
You wanted a nice, clean job, didn't you?
Oh, stop it.
If you'd have kept your mouth shut, we'd have had a good job in the Eagle Laundry.
Oh, sure. You know I ain't never had no experience washing eagles. You know that.
What you kicking about? The machinery do all the heavy work.
Yeah, I know. All I gotta do is lift the basket off the wagon, sort the clothes, put them in the boiler, lift the boiler up to the stove, empty the boiler, rinse them, turn the wringer, and the machinery, it do the rest.
Hey, boy, what house did this big piece of lace go to?
What lace? Well, what are you talking
about? Right there, that big piece of lace.
Oh, sure, that ain't lace.
No?
No, no, that was a sheet, that was. That go to that big brown house where that dog barks so much.
Oh, that dog won't hurt you. He wag his tail.
Yeah, but while he do that tail wagging business, he also bark. And I don't know which end to believe. I don't.
Oh, you was just a plain fool, that's all.
What'd you say?
Didn't you hear me?
Boy, if I had, I'd have smacked you right in the mouth. You know, you ain't overcrowded with no brain cells yourself. Didn't that man in the laundry with the big black mustache tell me you was doing twice as much work as me? I explained to him that you was foolish that way. I couldn't learn you no better. You was so dumb.
Don't you know who he was?
Well, how would I know him?
He's the boss of this laundry, that's who.
The boss?
Uh-huh.
Doggone. I wonder if he knew I was only joking. I wonder that.
That dumbhead. You ain't using that cranium for nothing but to hang your hat on.
Cranium?
Uh-huh.
You mean them red geraniums? Them flowers and posies and like that? What are you talking about anyhow?
Never mind that. Look where you're driving. Don't you see that sign what say one-way street?
Well, I'm only going one way.
Yeah, a cop come along and give you a ticket, though.
Boy, it's getting nowadays so you can't tell whether the policeman is gonna give you a ticket or sell you one.
Or drive on, fool.
What did keep you so long in that last house we stopped at? How come?
The maid had to find the woman's whereabouts.
Oh, I put them in the basket myself.
Put what in the basket?
Them whereabout things.
Oh, stop talking and look at that paper and see whereabouts we stops next.
Boy, you know I can't read that paper, you know that.
I thought you told me you got reading glasses yesterday.
Well, the man, he must make a mistake. Because I put them on, and still I can't read.
Yeah, what you need is spelling. Boy, it's getting so dark, I can hardly see this paper.
We better stop somewhere and get some of that red oil.
Red oil? What are you talking about, red oil?
Well, don't you know that our taillight is empty? Don't you know that?
Oh.
Here, boy, drive for a while, will you? I'm getting so fatigued, I hear.
How come you was always so tired?
Well, I don't know. It's sort of run in the family.
Oh, you mean it's hereditary?
No, no, no. It run in the family. You know, my father, he only weighed 3 pounds when he was born.
3 pounds? Well, did he live?
Oh, I don't remember. That was way back before my time. Don't bother me.